Wednesday 19, go ahead and grab your block. If you don't have a block, grab a pillow. Pause the video if you need to go get it. We're gonna start on our knees. This is what it will look like with the pillow. You just shove it under and sit back. So you're taking some pressure off of the knees and the ankles. I'm gonna use my block. But I just wanted to give you an idea of what it looks like with the pillow. If you have a block, you wanna be able to sit back on that block. Bring the knees in line with the hips and heels are directly under your glutes. Sitting up nice and tall with a nice long spine, relax the shoulders down. Nice long neck. We're gonna close the eyes for a moment. Hands can rest in your lap. We're gonna take a few breaths, just becoming present on the mat. Doing our best to leave any stresses off of the mat. Feel free to set an intention for your practice or your day. We're gonna count to four for each inhale and count to eight for each exhale. Let's begin with a deep breath in and let it all go. Deep breath in. Let it all go. One more time. And let it all go. Let's gently open our eyes. We're going to reach the arms up overhead and we're going to grab opposite elbows and then relax the shoulders. We're going to gently tip over to the right, keeping both sits bones on the pillow or the block, using the core to lift you back up into center. Come on over to the left, gently, keeping the chest open. And again, use the core to come back through center. Gently turn to the right and turn to the left and release. Twist over to the right, look over that shoulder, keeping the integrity in the spine. Come on over to the left, twisting, look over that shoulder, and come back. Seated cat-cow, we're gonna round through chin to chest, and then we open up the chest. Lift the chin towards the sky. Round through. We inhale as we open up through the lungs and the chest. And we exhale as we round through. Open it up. And exhale, round. Let's bring the right hand out, grab those four fingers, stretch out those wrists. Face the palm out, pull those four fingers under. Other hand. Face the palm out, pull those fingers under. Out to the sides, palms up, fingertips touch the shoulders. We open up through the chest, look up, and round through, elbows touch. Open up the chest, elbows touch. Inhale as the lungs open, and exhale as you contract. Open it up one more time. Inhale and exhale to contract. Keep the elbows lifted. Bring them out to the sides and do your shoulder rolls. You can make them as small or as big as you want. Reverse. Slide that left hand down, pull it in, look over that shoulder. other side. Left hand, left arm comes out, right hand slides down, pull it in. Look over that shoulder. Drop the right ear towards the right shoulder. Bring the right hand up. You can gently rest it on the head. We're not tugging, just gently rest. Bring those fingertips out to the left. And let's take it to the other side. Left ear drops towards the left shoulder. We gently rest the left hand on top of the head. Walk the right fingertips out. And release. Hands to heart. Bring your forehead to the hands, stretching through the back of the neck. And come on up. We're going to look up to the sky. Back through center, look over to the right. Come through center, look over to the left. Come through center. Let's remove the block and put it to the side. We're going to come into our tabletop. Hands under the shoulders, knees under the hips, flatten the feet, engage the core. From here, we're going to just drop the elbows almost down and then lift up. Drop the elbows almost down and lift. Start to match the breath to the movement. Think of it as like a musical beat. Back to neutral. Bring the right leg out and the left arm out. Engage the core by lifting the belly button. Bring everything out 30 degrees to the side and bring it in towards the center. Everything comes out 30 degrees back through the center. Bring it out. Keep the core engaged. One more time. Make sure you're not holding your breath. Come on back to neutral. This time the left leg comes out, right arm comes out. Engage the core by lifting the belly button. We come out 30 degrees and in. Match the breath. Stretch that right leg out, the ball of the foot on the mat, push back with the heel. Bring it in, take it to the other side, push back with that heel. We're going to sit back in a nice extended child's pose. We widen the knees, big toes touch. We sit back. If you find that when you're sinking your chest and forehead that your glutes pop up, sit up and come onto your forearms. Relax the neck, keep it in line with the spine. You can also use a block to rest your forehead on. If you need to make it a little higher, turn it on its side. If you don't have a block, make a pillow with your hands and rest your forehead on your hands. So those are just some options. Take three breaths here. We're going to round our backs through as we open up through the chest. lead with the tailbone coming back. Round through the back. Open up through the chest. Lead with the tailbone to come back. Round through. Lead with the tailbone. One more time. Come on back up to neutral. We come into our tabletop. We slowly walk the hands out in front as we melt the chest to the mat. Coming into puppy pose. If you feel any pain in your shoulders or upper back, widen your arms. Take a few deep breaths here. And we're going to walk those hands back in, coming into our tabletop. Curl those toes under, come into your down dog. Walk your dog as you take some deep breaths, filling those lungs with oxygen. And let's step it up to the front of the mat, coming into our forward fold. Grab opposite elbows, ragdoll, sway back and forth. Deep bend in the knees, belly resting on the thighs. And we slowly roll it up. Head comes up last. And let's heel toe the feet close together so knees are touching. And we're going to come into chair pose. Grab opposite elbows, open up through that chest. We're going to bring all the weight into the right foot. Step back, open up through the chest. Release those arms. And lean forward, bringing the arms behind. We lift up, arms come back in front. Hands to heart. Find your balance. See if you can lift into your warrior three. Fingertips come to the ground. We step it up. Forward fold. Micro bend in the knees. Wrap your arms around the backs of your legs, grabbing opposite elbows. Slowly roll it up. Coming into Tadasana. Heel toe those feet together. And let's come into our chair pose. Sit back. Grab the elbows. Bringing all of our weight into our left foot. We step back. Into our high lunge, we open it up. Release the arms, bring them in front. As we bring them behind, we lean forward. And then we come back, lifting up, hands to heart. Push off, come into your warrior three. Fingertips reach for the ground, step it up. Forward fold. Roll it up. This time, arms come overhead. And grab opposite elbows. Come on over to the right. Hips come out to the left. Chest is open. Deep breath in. Exhale, take it to the other side. Come back through center. We're going to heel toe those feet closer together. Come back into our chair pose. This time, we lift the right leg, bring it down, feet come back together, and lift the left leg, bring it down. Forward fold, hands to the shins, flat back, shoulders roll back, chest opens up, forward fold, hands to the mat. Let's take it back to our high plank. We're going to drop our knees down. From here, I'm going to turn my left knee out, opening up into our gate pose. Lift that right leg and lower as you breathe. From here, knee to elbow. Come on back, both hands to the mat, knees are still bent. We take it over to the other side, bending the right knee now, left leg straightens out to the side. Coming into our gate pose, left arm to the sky. We lift the left leg and lower as we breathe. This time, knee to elbow. Make sure you're breathing. Come on back. Sit back in a regular child's pose. Glutes to your heels, walking forward, forehead melts to the mat, relax through the shoulders and the arms, take a few deep breaths. Come on back to your tabletop. Let's come into our down dog. Take a moment to walk your dog, pedal through the feet. Deep breaths. Lift the tailbone towards the sky, melt the chest. On your next breath in, right leg comes high, three-legged dog. We're gonna exhale, bring it through the center, and we're gonna tap that knee three times and lift it towards the chest. Come on back up, three-legged dog. Deep breath in. We exhale, three more taps. Come on back up, three-legged, deep breath in. This time as we exhale, we're gonna step it wide, that foot halfway on, halfway off the mat. Lizard pose. From here, we're going to lower down into our half push-ups and lift. Lower and lift. Lower and lift. And swing that leg back around to your high plank. This is your chance to take a vinyasa. You can drop your knees, lift the heels to modify. Use two blocks to land on. Or deep breath in, come forward, exhale, flip the feet and open up. Bend the knees, curl the toes, lift with the tailbone. Back to your down dog, pedal through the feet. Take some deep breaths. Next breath in, left leg comes high, three-legged dog. We're going to exhale, three taps. Come on back up, deep breath in. Exhale, three more taps. Come on back up, three-legged dog. Big inhale. This time we exhale, step it wide, half on, half off the mat. Stay lifted on that back leg. lizard pose. From here, we're gonna do our half push-ups. Keep those elbows into your sides. Come on back to your plank. Drop the knees down, sit back. Regular child's pose. Take three breaths. Let's reach the arms overhead. Deep breath in. Let's exhale. Dive it down the middle. Come on into your halfway lift. And forward fold. Hands to the mat. Step it back. Drop the knees down. Let's swing them around. Come onto your back. Two more at a time. Give yourself a good morning stretch. Arms overhead. Big stretch here. Big stretch. And from here, come on up to the forearms. You can tuck those fingers under your glutes a little bit. You want to make sure you're not sinking in your shoulders here, your collarbone. Lift up and open. We're going to bring knee to chest and lay it back down. Slow and controlled as we breathe. Breath will help you so much more in any poses, any core work we do. I know it's hard to remember to breathe. It took me a long time to remember to breathe. You just have to keep working at it. I try to remind you guys as often as I can. It might get redundant, but it's hard to remember on your own. Until you start matching the breath with movement, going to be really easy to forget. Bring it down. Stay up on those forearms. Lift the legs. We're going to drop the right leg down and pulse. Bring it up. Deep breath in. Left leg comes down and pulse. Back, hug your knees in, give yourself a little massage, rock back and forth. Take a deep breath. We're going to turn on our sides, and I want you to make a straight line with your body. You can bring that bottom arm out and use it as a pillow, but make sure you're nice and straight so you're not like wobbling. Find your sweet spot. You can use that top arm, use those fingertips as a kickstand. We're gonna lift the top leg, bring it behind, and draw circles, but behind us. So I'm not coming in front of that bottom leg, I'm staying behind. And breathe.
reverse the circle. Gently come down, unshimmy the shoulders first, and come down one vertebrae at a time. We bring knees into the chest, and we bring the nose to meet the knees, counteracting the pose, counteracting the spine. I was going to say counterbalancing, but we're not balancing. Let's bring that right leg over. We're going to do reclined pigeon, left leg parallel with the sky, wrap those hands behind the thigh, bring everything in, keep the tailbone on the mat, keep both feet flexed and active. This should feel really good. If it doesn't, I suggest pulling back a little bit. From here, you can do a little baby rock. Left leg crosses over, right leg parallel with the sky, wrap those hands around the thigh, bring everything in, active feet, flex those feet, tailbone on the mat, and we breathe. And release. We're going to come into happy baby, so bring those feet towards the sky, bent knees, grab the outside of each foot. We're going to keep the tailbone on the mat as we push those knees towards the mat. And here you can also do a baby rock back and forth. So you can see me coming onto our backs now. We're going to walk the legs over to the left corner of the bottom of the mat. And we're going to bring arms overhead. We're going to bring both arms over to the top left corner, making a crescent moon shape with our body. Grab a hold of the right wrist if you'd like. You don't have to. You want a little bit extra stretch, you can cross that top leg over. Make sure both both shoulder blades are on the ground, both glutes are on the ground, and breathe. Come back through center, walk the legs over to the right, bring the upper body over towards the top right corner of your mat. You can grab that wrist if you want. Again, you can cross the leg over for an extra stretch. Drop the knees over to the right. Left arm comes out. Look over towards that hand. If you want to cross the bottom leg over the top leg, go for it. Just keep both shoulder blades on the mat. You don't have to cross that leg over. You can stay right here. Come on back through center. We're going to pop the hips over to the right this time. Knees come down over to the left. Right arm comes out. We look towards that hand. You can stay here or you can cross the bottom leg over the top, but keep both shoulder blades on the mat. And breathe. And gently unravel. Come on back through center. We're going to do our Shavasana, or Savasana, whatever you want to say, on our backs. I highly recommend, don't get up like that. Y'all already know, turn to your side. I highly recommend a pillow under the knees. And if you need to lay back gently, one vertebrae at a time. Relax everything. Fix your glutes. Arms can come out to the sides and just completely melt your body into the mat, letting go, surrendering, slowly turning off your mind, turning off your thoughts. I want you guys to breathe just like you did in the beginning of the class, 4 counts for the inhale, 8 counts for the exhale. As you guys meditate, I'm going to play my little drum, and then I'll join you for a little meditation at the end. Thank you.
slowly out of your corpse pose, turning onto your side in fetal position, and meeting me in a comfortable seat. If you want to sit up on a block or sit up on a pillow, I suggest that. We're going to take a deep breath in as we lift the arms over the head. We're going to hold the breath at the top. And as we exhale, I want you to release any negativity in your life, just any negative thoughts, anyone trying to cause you harm or hurt, just let it go. Send them forgiveness and just keep your light around you. Keep your life surrounded in light. Don't let anyone take your light from you, ever. Just look the other way, don't engage, and I promise you, you will be so much better off. Let's take a deep breath in through the nose as we reach the arms overhead. Hold it at the top. And exhale, let it go. One more deep breath in. Hold at the top. Let it go. Hands to heart. Thank you guys so much for practicing with me today. It was such an honor to practice with you, and I hope to see you back for tomorrow, day 20. Thank you guys so much. Have a great rest of your day. Namaste.